Turkey's on a diplomatic push. It's trying to convince governments around the world to take over schools run by Fetullah Gulen. He's the U.S.-based businessman and cleric accused by Turkey of plotting the July 15 coup attempt last year. Schools and universities belonging to Gulenists can be found in more than 160 countries. But Turkey's president says those schools are part of a strategy by the Fetullah terrorist organization, or FETÖ, to gain political and economic influence in those countries.
The FETÖ terrorist group is using the schools to recruit militants in those countries, not to serve people. We want to fight FETÖ for the security of our neighbors and brotherly countries, not just for ourselves.
The Bosphorus Bridge, which you can see behind me, became a symbol of the resistance of the attempted coup. Shortly after, Turkey began a clampdown on institutions linked to the Gulenists. And an important part of that has been to try to get the group's overseas schools handed over to the Turkish authorities. Part of Ankara's strategy is to take over Gulen-linked schools in Africa and provide education services through state-funded foundations. The Gulenists opened their first schools in Africa in the 1990s. Since then, they've spread across the continent. So far, the Turkish government says 200 Gulen-run schools, including 100 in Africa, have been restricted, shut down, or taken over.
Somali government was the first country to respond to close those schools. And also, the Turkish government was also responded very quickly, sending the Maarif Foundation to take over so that we avoid the education gap.
But authorities in Kenya, Tanzania, and Nigeria have refused to close them down. Other countries have taken action on their own. In the United States, the FBI is reportedly investigating the schools for improper contracting. In 2000, Uzbekistan shut down all Gulen-associated schools operating there, and similar steps were taken in Russia. In both cases, people running the schools were accused of spying for the Americans, an allegation they deny. Today, the Turkish government sees academic institutions abroad as an instrument of its soft power in Africa, spreading the country's language and culture. And the government in Ankara argues that it alone has this responsibility, not someone wanted for trying to stage a coup. Christine Pirovolakis, TRT World.